Good morning. This is All India Radio Kohima. The morning news read by Jonas Yentan. Nagaland government has announced an ex-gratia relief of 5 lakh rupees to the next of kin of the deceased who were killed by the security forces on December 4 in Oting village area of Mon district that resulted in the death of 13 civilians. The government also extended ex-gratia for the injured persons who are being treated with medical care. In a press release, Nagaland Chief Secretary J. Alam said, while the state government condemns the incident, it is taking all possible steps to maintain law and order and ensure peace and harmony. The Chief Secretary said a team led by Minister P. Paiwang Konyak, DGP and Commissioner Nagaland is camping in Mon district to monitor the situation, while Deputy Chief Minister Y. Button, who was in New Delhi, had rushed back to Mon directly from Guwahati. Alam said Chief Minister Nipirio will be visiting Mon this morning, accompanied by cabinet colleagues and senior government officers, to take an on-the-spot assessment of the situation and pay respects to the deceased. He will be interacting with the state government functionaries and civil society organization leaders in Mon. High-level review of the situation will be held today at the level of Chief Secretary and other senior officers. The additional Secretary NE, Government of India, will also take part in the meeting. In view of the prevailing situation in Mon district, Deputy Commissioner Mon Thavasilan K has ordered the imposition of curfew under Section 144 CRPC 1973 in the district. The order prohibits the gathering of more than five persons at a time in public. All vehicular movement of non-essential nature, including passenger vehicles, are also prohibited. The order issued yesterday comes into immediate effect and will remain in force till further orders. Nagaland government has said, as a mark of respect and solidarity to the deceased and the victims, the events of the ongoing Hornbill festival at Kisama will start with 2 minutes silence and prayer every day. The government said that the cultural activities at Kisama will not be held today and activities will resume only after the completion of the funeral services at sunset. It said while the events of the Hornbill will continue, the sympathy, solidarity and prayers of the entire Naga community are with the families and loved ones of the deceased. The state government also appreciated the majority of the statement issued by the Eastern Nagaland People's Organization and once again assured that no stone will be left unturned to ensure that justice prevails and appropriate actions as per the law of the land are taken. A 6-hour total shutdown has been imposed all over the Naga inhabited areas today. The band is being called by the Naga Students' Federation, NSF, in protest against the actions of the Indian Armed Forces. The band, which commenced from 6 a.m. this morning, will last till 12 noon. Only medical and other emergency services, police, weddings with a commuter carrying a copy of the waiting card, and other emergency services and students appearing for various exams have been exempted from the band. However, all paramilitary forces and armed forces are asked not to make any movements during the duration of the band. The NSF demanded the central government to set up a court-monitored committee headed by a retired Supreme Court judge to conduct an impartial probe into the incident to immediately withdraw the Armed Forces Special Powers Act from all Naga inhabited areas without delay. The Federation also demanded for special assembly session of NLA to be convened at the earliest and to adopt a resolution for revocation of the controversial AFSPA and a befitting compensation to all the victims. Several political parties from across the states, civil society organizations, tribal hohos, churches and several other NGOs have condemned the killings of the innocent civilians by the security armed forces. NDPP, BJP, NPF, NPCC, Sumi Hoho, Angami Public Organization, Au Senden, Lotha Hoho, Rengma Hoho, Nagaland Zelyang People Organization, various tribal youth organizations, student unions and activists have condemned the incidents and extended their condolences to the bereaved families of the deceased. In the condemnation letter issued by various political leaders, civil societies and activists have voiced the revocation of the Armed Forces Special Powers Act in the state. Meanwhile, the Nagaland Baptist Church Council called upon all its constituent member churches in Nagaland to observe corporate prayers on December 7 at 6 a.m. for their bereaved families and for peace. With that, we come to the end of the morning news. Have a nice day.